In this video, I will demonstrate how to add cell graphs to list tables and crosstabs in SAS Visual Analytics 8.4, but these techniques can be applied to earlier versions of SAS Visual Analytics. Cell graphs are applied to measure data items. Therefore, list tables or crosstabs must have a measure data item assigned to the object. There are two types of cell graphs, bar and heat map. The bar size or cell color is determined by the relative value within the column. This means only for the data visible in the object. If you apply a filter to the object, then the range of that bar and cell color will update as the data available to the object changes. Cell graphs allow report users to easily identify outliers. Let's get started with the demonstration. I will be using SAS Visual Analytics 8.4 for the hands-on portion of this video, but again, the same techniques can be used for earlier releases of SAS Visual Analytics. We will start with a pre-built report. As this is an enhancement feature, cell graphs can be applied to any existing reports with a list table or crosstab displaying measure information. In this report, you can see I have two page prompts, one for year and one for product line. My list table is displaying product and four measures. Two are for product material cost average and two are for profit. For the first column, let's add a bar cell graph. First, we need to click the list table to activate the object, and then we'll use the options pane. Scroll all the way down until you find the cell graph grouping. Then you will click on New Cell Graph and select Product Material Cost Average. You can see that by default, the cell graph applied is bar. We could go ahead and select a different color, and we can select placement of our bar, left of text, right of text, or replace text. If I were to select a product line value, such as action figure, we can see that the bar automatically adjusts to a different size. If I click promotional, again, the bar changes relative to the data available in the object. Now let's add a cell graph of type heat map to the same column as next to it. Click on our list table to activate the object, and again, use the options pane. Scroll all the way down and select New Cell Graph, and we're going to select Product Material Cost Average Duplicate. Again, the default is cell graph of type bar, and we want to change it to heat map. Notice that the entire cell is colored. There's no option to select the placement. Here we customize the gradient. And again, notice the same way that the color of the gradient auto-configures depending on the data that is actually visible in the object. The next two columns are both displaying profit, and then we can make it a little bit more interesting as we can see there are both positive and negative values for this field. For the first column of profit, let's go ahead and add a bar cell graph. Click on the list table to activate it. Use the options pane and scroll all the way down. Select New Cell Graph for profit. We are going to choose the bar. In this case, we're going to replace the text and style the bar black. Notice how the bar centers along a zero axis. To more easily identify the negative values in this column, let's define a display rule. With our list table active, I'm going to open the rules pane and add a new rule for profit. For my expression, anytime profit is less than zero, I am going to style it red. For the format, I'm going to style it dark red and the background a light red. Here we can easily discern which values are less than zero. Again, let's check it out when we apply a filter for action figure. Here now it's very easy to see the profit values that are less than zero. When the display rule is not met, the values are shown black and positive. Let's do the same thing for the last column profit duplicate, except using a heat map cell graph. And again, we will apply a display rule. Click on the list table to activate it. First, let's apply our cell graph. New cell graph for profit duplicate. We are going to select type heat map. For the gradient, we'll do gray up to black. Notice how the heat map automatically formats the text and background color to make it easier to see. But we're still going to add our display rule. Our new rule is going to be for profit duplicate, where anytime profit duplicate is less than zero, we're going to format it dark red and the background light red. Here we get a little bit of different behavior. We can see that the text color is red, but the heat map cell graph styling takes precedence and the background for the display rule will not impact it in this case. Also notice down below in my list table, I have totals turned on, but the total style is not impacted by the addition of cell graphs. Now let's look at crosstabs. As you can imagine, the results are very similar. The first cell graph we will add is a heat map for the revenue measure. Similarly to the list table, we click on the crosstab to activate it and use our options pane. Scrolling down all the way to the bottom, we can add a new cell graph for revenue. The type of cell graph we want is heat map. We can customize the gradient. For a style such as this, I would most likely sort descending by revenue for our greatest year. We can also add an abbreviated numerical value representation for revenue. This will allow the heat map cell graph and the color gradient to speak even louder. Notice, just like the list table, that the totals in the crosstabs are not impacted. The same will hold true for subtotals if they were turned on. Now let's add one more additional measure to this crosstab. From the roles pane, I'm going to activate my crosstab and add unit yield actual. Since I had the abbreviated numerical value selected for revenue, it automatically had that option selected for the entire crosstab. If I wanted to deselect unit yield for it to not show abbreviated numerical value, I would select it here. But let's go ahead and add a bar cell graph for this measure. Scroll down and find the cell graph subcategory. Add a new cell graph for unit yield actual, and let's leave the default bar placement. Again, sorting on this column will allow the user to quickly identify and group data trends. For more information, please refer to the SAS Visual Analytics documentation or check out one of my other videos or blogs. Thank you, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.